BBC Audio presents Father Paolo Baldi Mysteries, the complete BBC radio crime series starring David Threlfall as Father Paolo Baldi.
And now the first in a new series of murder mysteries. For David Threlfall as Paolo Baldi, in Baldi.
How's me rye and chips doing there, Johnny?
Almost ready, Liam. Hey! Hey! Monica! Ali! What are you doing up there? What's up?
That messer you call your other son. He staggers in, and what does he do then, huh? He starts nicking things, that's all.
A mouthful of grappa, and I wasn't stealing.
Rage. If your mama was alive, it would break her heart to see brothers fight like this.
Mama kept this stronzo out of the house. You brought him back in.
He's your brother. Now what he's done, is done.
Come on, Ali. Don't let him spoil the evening for us.
Any chance of me raying chips there, Jenny?
Oh, sorry, Liam.
Okay. Oh, I forgot. Please, the text for next week is Hardy's Aristotle and the Language of the Phenomenal. Okay, thank you.
Dr. Baldi.
Oh, Professor Graham.
May I have a word?
A word from the Dean. I'm honoured.
As you should be, Dr. Baldi. Now, I've had a rather peculiar request from the Gardaí.
Good Lord.
Oh, no. They don't want to arrest you, Dr. Baldi, for your views on Heidegger or anything like that. No, it seems that they would like you to assist them with an investigation. A detective inspector Meehan called.
Ah. Sorry, I don't know who that is.
I trust it won't distract from your valuable work. Second year philosophy is a sweeping canvas.
Yeah. Well, still, assist them with an investigation. It's had a ring to it, hasn't it?
Dr. Baldi, thank you for coming.
Detective Inspector Mann?
You're expecting a big strapping fella, right? The Gardaí have emerged blinking into the 90s, Dr. Baldi. So a woman can rise to the dizzy heights of Detective Inspector. You're a professor of philosophy yourself, I believe.
Well, a junior lecturer, I'm afraid. Dr. Graham likes to make things sound important.
Oh, well, take a seat.
Thank you.
Let me fill you in on this thing.
Right.
You know Parletti's?
On Woodbine Road, the chippy?
That one. Old Parletti, Gianni, was attacked and robbed last night.
Oh, that's terrible. Poor old chap.
The chipper is actually run by his son and daughter-in-law. Mm-hmm. But Monday's their night off and Gianni takes over.
Right.
When his son came home, he found his father lying on the floor.
Was he badly hurt?
Unconscious. Got hit from behind. He's recovering, though. Mm.
And is there a suspect?
There's an arrest. A young local fella, Darren Todd, well known to us and to them. Gianni's son rang us and we picked him up two streets away, still carrying the weapon and cash from the till.
Oh. And what did he hit Mr. Parletti with?
A snooker cue.
Oh, does he play snooker?
This kid? No. He says he found the cue lying beside the old man. We presume he stole it, though we're not sure where just yet. Mm. There's loads of snooker clubs around.
Oh. It sounds as if you have it under control.
We have.
Oh.
Sorry. I should have made it clear. What we want you to do... See, the old man lapses into Italian when he gets upset and...
Oh, you want me to translate? Right, of course.
What did you think we wanted you to do? Solve the crime?
No. This is stupid of me. I had a notion... you know Umberto Eco?
The name of the rose, that fellow?
Yes, but lots of other things as well, you know. Professor Eco is a semioticist.
What's that when it's at home?
Well, it's a big word for signs. It's a fascinating branch of philosophy, actually. Well, I'm a sort of amateur semioticist.
Well, Dr. Baldi, there are signs here, but they all point one way. You're welcome to observe, of course, but really, what we want you to do is translate.
Translate.
Mr. Parletti.
Another policeman.
No, Mr. Parletti.
The priest?
This gentleman isn't a policeman or a priest. Dr. Baldi is a professor. He's Italian.
Ah, bene. Da dove?
La famiglia viene dall'Aquila.
Abruzzese. Molto feroce.
Dr. Baldi is going to translate, or at least that was the idea.
Translate? I live 50 years here. Parlo inglese perfettamente.
Of course, Mr. Parletti. Now, would you mind telling us what happened?
I already told you.
You lapsed. You began to speak Italian, Mr. Parletti, when you became angry.
Okay. One more time, okay? I was working in the shop. I come out to the front to lock up, and this guy hits me.
You saw him? Sorry, Inspector.
Did you see your attacker?
How could I see him? I was leaning over the counter for the light switch. My back is to the door. Whoosh! And in his throne, so he hit me from behind.
Then how did you... Sorry, Inspector. Sorry, how did he know who it was?
His son arrived in, like, moments later and called us. Isn't that right, Mr. Parletti? Your son came in.
Mia figlia. Oh, mia figlia.
Alessandro, oh, Ali, dear, runs the shop.
That's not right.
Tutti risparmi.
Well,
tutti risparmi.
He's very upset. How much money was taken?
About £70. Basically, the night's takings.
He used the word risparmi. It normally means savings.
The boy definitely wasn't carrying savings. Unless Mr. Parletti here was very improvident.
Gianni, what do you mean when you say risparmi? Did the thief take your savings?
No, non risparmi.
Non risparmi.
Soldi. Un sacco di soldi.
Not savings, money. He says he just used the wrong word.
Now, what about the boy?
What about him?
Well, you said he'd never attacked anyone before.
Not that we know of.
So there's a discontinuity.
Dr. Baldi, there's always a first blow, okay? And we caught him red-handed right after the attack. If you don't mind, I'd like you to translate for us. Nothing more.
I forgot.
I'm sorry. I sounded a bit...
bossy.
Bossy cow. You'll have to forgive me. I have the superintendent from hell on my back. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate your help. Would you be willing to translate for Gianni again if we need it?
Of course. I'd be delighted, Inspector.
Tina. It's shorter than Inspector.
Of course, Tina. Short for Martina.
Yes.
Paolo. Short for Paolo.
Hello. Can I help you?
Hello. Yes, I was here a moment ago. Dr. Baldi.
Gerard De Hagen, Mr. Parletti's solicitor.
Oh, hello.
Terrible thing, this.
Yes, terrible.
How's he coming along?
He seems fine.
He's not that kind of doctor.
What did you say, Gianni?
I'm not a medical doctor. I'm one of the useless kind. Philosophy.
Ah, I see. What's a PhD doing here? Are you a friend?
He's from the Abruzzi. I don't trust anyone from the Abruzzi.
I came back to ask Mr. Paletti here about a word he used. Risparmi.
What does it matter? Risparmi, soldi. My life is ruined. My son's life is ruined. Either way.
Well, there's my answer, and I'd better be going then.
Fine. He has stuff to sign.
Oh, what's that?
Dr. Baldi, with respect, I'm not sure that's any business.
Sorry, I meant, what time is it?
It's 10 to 12.
Oh, well, I'm late. Right, arrivederci. It's all right, I don't want chips. I wondered if I might talk to you about the robbery. Hello, Alessandro Paletti.
Cardi?
I'm helping your father. Traduccio io.
Da dove vieni?
Dagli Abruzzi.
Siamo napoletano, eh? Huh? Entra.
Thank you.
Monica, this is...
Paolo Baldi. Piacere.
Monica is an Italian.
Ah, then... hello.
Hello.
Could I ask you about... you, Ali, about the night of the attack?
This is the 50th time.
Still.
We went out, we came home.
Where did you go?
The Oasis. Monica had a drink with her girlfriends. I watched the football.
You came home together?
Yeah, we came home early.
Why?
Because I didn't...
Well, because she was worried about the old man. It always is. I mean, this place gets rough late on.
Right. And you found your father?
On the floor behind the counter. The door was open.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.